Nick, I will tell you, show you the correct method of performing tuning fork hearing tests. So as you know, tuning fork hearing tests, they are very vital, they are very important part of the ear examination. And usually we perform three tests, tuning fork tests, which are Rinne's test, Weber test, and absolute bone conduction. So these three tests, they are to be performed in each and every case of patient who are coming with a history of hearing loss. And the tuning fork test, they will tell us whether the patient is having conductive hearing loss or whether the patient is having sensory hearing loss. And even in some of the tests, we can get some idea also whether it is mild, moderate, severe, or profound hearing loss. So one by one, first I will show you the Rinne's test and then Weber. And in the last, we will see the absolute bone conduction test. We take three hearing loss this tuning forks, and this one is at this 256 hertz, then 512, and then 1024. So these three tuning forks we employ for this tuning fork hearing test. So I will usually what we opt is for 512, that is said to be the best. So with the 512 I will perform all these tests. And then you should know the different parts of the tuning fork. So this is called the base of the tuning fork. And this is the stem of the tuning fork. This is the joint and these are the two prongs. And for charging we can strike it at our elbow and we can charge it in this way. Now first I will show you the tuning fork, Rinne's test. So in Rinne's test, what we do, we compare the air conduction with the bone conduction. So normally, air conduction is better than the bone conduction. So if the air conduction is better than the bone conduction, then we call that Rinne's is positive. And if it becomes just reverse, if the bone conduction becomes better than air conduction, then that is called Rinne's negative, and that occurs in cases of conductive hearing loss. So the patients who are having normal hearing or patients who are having mild or to moderate sensory hearing loss, in these patients Rinne's test will be positive. And the patients who are suffering from conductive hearing loss, in those patients the Rinne's test will be negative. So again I will repeat, positive means AC better than BC, negative means BC better than AC. BC stands for bone conduction and AC stands for air conduction. So for testing the air conduction, we'll put the charge tuning fork just near the external auditory canal. And then we put the same tuning fork on the master bone. Can you hear this?
Yes.
Can you hear this?
Yes.
Which is better, first or second?
First is better.
First was better. So in this particular case, air conduction is better than the bone conduction. It means patient is having Rinne's positive. So either the patient, this patient is having normal hearing or the patient is having the mild to moderate sensory hearing loss. We demonstrate you the Weber test. So for Weber test, we put the charge tuning fork on the in the center of the forehead or on the upper central incisors. Take out your specs. As well as mask both. Yes. Can you hear?
Yes.
On which side do you hear better?
Both ear.
Both ear equal. Mm-hmm. Okay. So in this case, Weber is centralized. It is not getting lateralized to any side. So in this method, we put the tuning fork on the base center of the forehead, or we can put even on the upper central incisor also like this. Modulo. Bata the upper central incisor. Murukul? Yes. Can you hear?
Yeah.
On both the sides same?
Yes.
Yes. So in this patient, as I was telling you, the Weber is not getting lateralized. He is hearing the sounds of both the tuning fork equal on both the sides. So this is no centralization. But say if the patient is hears better in the left ear, in this case, it is centralized, it is not getting lateralized. But if the patient says that he hears better in the left ear, So means labor is getting lateralized to the left ear. Now if it is getting to the left, it is lateralizing to the left ear, then now there are two possibilities. One is that this patient is having conductive hearing loss in the left ear. And second possibility is that the patient is having sensory neural hearing loss in the right ear. Demonstrate you the correct method, correct technique of performing the absolute bone conduction. Because it is called absolute, because we will occlude the axonotic canal. So patient will be hearing only through the bone conduction. So these vibrations of the bone conduction, they will directly go to the cochlea. So it will tell us the status of the cochlea. So if the ABC is normal, means there is no cochlear involvement, sensory neural involvement. But if there is, abnormal, then that will mean that there is pathology of the cochlea or sensory, or patient is having sensory neural hearing loss. So after charging tuning fork, then I will put it in behind the mesial bone and I will occlude the axonotic canal. So when you stop hearing, then let us know. And I will put it on my bone. I can't hear. It means patient doesn't have any sensory neural hearing loss. Patient can have conductive hearing loss in this case, but patient doesn't have sensory neural hearing loss. So if the absolute bone conduction test is normal, it means patient doesn't have sensory neural hearing loss. If the patient is in the renis is negative, then means bone conduction is better than the ear conduction. And if renis is positive, means ear conduction is better than bone conduction. So if the bone conduction is better than the ear conduction, it means patient is having conductive hearing loss. So in the conductive hearing loss, the patient will have diseases, pathology in the axonotic canal of the tympanic membrane and the middle ear. So if there is any pathology of these three diseases, patient will have conductive hearing loss. And if the patient is having pathology of the cochlea or beyond that eighth nerve, then that is called sensory neural hearing loss. And in sensory neural hearing loss, ABC will get reduced. So in the today's session, we saw the tuning fork hearing test. So mainly this tuning fork hearing test, as I told you previously also, they are performed to know whether the patient is having conductive hearing loss or the sensory hearing loss. So in the Rinne's test, we compare ear conduction with the bone conduction. Normally, ear conduction is better than the bone conduction. And in cases of early sensory hearing loss, again, the ear conduction is better than the bone conduction. And if the bone conduction is better than the ear conduction in the Rinne's test, that means Rinne is negative. And that means patient is having conductive hearing loss, because the BC will become better than the AC. And in cases of Weber test, we are testing only the bone conduction. So you put the charged tuning fork on the center of the forehead, or we can put on the upper central incisors. And then we ask the patient on which side he hears better. So if the patient is hearing, say, better in the right ear, then there are two possibilities. Either the patient is having right ear conductive hearing loss, or the patient is having left ear sensory hearing loss. And just to confirm whether it is conductive, we can perform the again, the Rinne test we can perform, and we can perform in ABC also. In absolute bone conduction, as the name suggests, patient will hear only through the bone conduction, because in this test we will occlude the external auditory canal. So ear conduction will be blocked. So patient will have only bone conduction. So these sound waves, they will directly go to the cochlea through mesial bone. So if the ABC is reduced, or if the ABC is not abnormal, it means patient is having sensory neural hearing loss. And if it is normal, then that means patient doesn't have any sensory neural hearing loss. So if we perform all these three tests, definitely we can say then the patient, whether the patient is having conductive hearing loss or the patient is having sensory hearing loss. In cases of profound sensory neural hearing loss in one ear, and we perform the Rinne's test, then Rinne's can be negative. That is called Rinne's false negative. Okay, because the patient is having profound hearing loss, so when he will put the tuning fork in front of the ear canal, patient will not hear anything. And when we put the same tuning fork on the base of the mesial bone, so patient will hear in the another ear. And due to that, it can become false negative. So in cases of unilateral profound hearing loss, we should be a little careful in interpreting the Rinne's test. And that we can perform with the help of Weber test. Or in cases of this false negative, if we perform the Weber, ideally it should go toward the conductive hearing loss side. But in this case, patient will hear on the opposite side. Okay, thank you.